And so what was that creation? Let's talk about Berea. You realize that you are clay in God's hands? But what happens when you take yourself out of God's hands? Well, then you're clay in the devil's hands. And what can the devil do to God? God can make something really great, but when we don't put ourselves in God's hands and we give ourselves to the world, sometimes you end up seeing this abomination compared to what you could be with God. When we end up changing our lives, and the whole idea of repentance, I was looking at Yeshua the other day, and I was looking at the name on it. It was the Yod Shin Vav Ayin. But I put a hey at the end of it, and I noticed that when they took the hey and they brought it back to the beginning, it ended up changing it to where it actually showed the meaning for to turn. And so the whole idea of repentance was to turn around. When we repent, Yeshua, you know, it was to actually turn back towards God, to turn back towards Christ and understand that what we're doing is we're taking the clay away from the adversary and we're taking it away from the devil and we're giving it to God. You're taking that clay that is your life, your body, your mind, your soul, and your spirit, and you put it into God's hands. So sometimes God says, what in the world is this? He looks at what the adversary has done, what the world's done to you, and he says, this is what I meant to make at all. But he changes it. He's able to break you down. David said, make me a contrite heart, O Lord. By doing that is the essence of adding that fire and the water that is the Holy Spirit that breaks us down, then solidifies us within God. By understanding that that water, that fury that God has, that can tear us down and create that contrite heart. Well, that's a portion of God reshaping our life. He looked at the creation that was without God and he said, this isn't what I wanted. He takes that Holy Spirit, he washes you clean, breaks you down. And when you're broken down, you look at yourself and you're sitting there repenting in tears and saying, I didn't know this is what salvation was like, but that's just a portion of it. That's when you're perfectly moldable. God can do anything he wants with you. That's when God starts to build you up, to shape you, to put you on that turning wheel, spin you around in the cycles of life and put you through a season, put you on another revolution, put you through another season and revolve you again. And as he does, each time you make that revolution, God forms you up, making you more and more closer to the image of perfection that he has within his hands.